Grace and peace from God our Father, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Welcome to SpreadingTruthMinistry.com on YouTube, and thank you for viewing. Take a few moments and subscribe, like this video, make a comment. I thought to myself, I said, listen, it's been a while since I've actually made a video, and I think that if I'm going to have a channel, I definitely need to put something out there, and so I thought this would be a good time to do it. Everything's quiet, everything's peaceful. It's a really a good time to hear from the Lord, and I'm just grateful. I am so grateful to God. It's been not a long week, but I say within this week there was definitely some challenging moments, and it's to God be the glory, all of it. It's to God be the glory. Like today I was in route home and I was driving, and I tell you, the roads were bad. We had a storm out here in the east, and you know, we were smacked with snow and the roads weren't as clear. And as I was driving, my car began to swerve and slide all on the highway. And thank God the car that was near me got out my way, and I started swerving and swerving some more. And I swerved around and almost made like a S, and then turned back around and turned the total opposite direction and stopped. And I was so close to the railing till it wasn't even funny. I thought I was going to either hit the railing or go off the railing. I didn't know what was going to happen. All I knew is I was calling on the name of the Lord Jesus and pleading the blood as I was driving this car, but yet with the calmness and yet with the peace of God upon me. And then I just, you know, felt like, you know, I don't know what's going to happen, but I just believe it's going to work out. And so the car was at a, you know, it stopped at an awkward spot. There was a semi truck and another car approaching. They weren't too close. They were far away enough for me to kind of back it up and turn the car around and continue going in the right direction. So praises be to God, because it could have been so much worse. As I continued down the road, I seen a car that went like past the railing off into the ditch. So, and I was like, that could have been me for real. So, I mean, I'm just grateful to God. I mean, like I said, things, you know, did transpire. Things, you know, did happen. But yet, God has been so merciful and so kind to me that I just want to magnify the things that, you know, that God has done, and praises to his name, because he did not have to be merciful to me. I could have been out in that ditch somewhere. I could have been, you know, taken to the hospital, to the emergency room, or God knows what, or just right now people could be writing my obituary. So, you know, to God be the glory that I'm alive and well. So I'm like, listen, I gotta do this video. I gotta do something. I gotta share something. And I did, like, what I do sometimes is I do like a pre-take of a video and just kind of do whatever God has inspired me to say. And in that, as I was talking, the thought came to me regarding Job, in the book of Job, and the conversation between God and Satan, and when God said, have you considered my servant Job? And oftentimes we as believers, we go through so much. And I'm sorry, as time continues, you know, up until the day that Jesus returns, his second advent, when he comes back again, we're going to continue to go through. It's going to be an increase. You know, if we think we're going through now, we ain't seen nothing yet. We're going to continue to go through. So it's time that we buckle in there, and we get in there and get rooted in God, and get so that regardless of what comes our way from day to day, that we'll be able to stand. And so when he said to Satan, you know, have you considered my servant Job? Like I said, oftentimes we say, woe is me, I'm going through, this is happening financially, personally, spiritually, the devil's on my track. Oh my, you know, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, oh Lord, please help me, please. You know, we never get to the point to say, you know what? Thank you, Father. Despite of what I'm going through, there's some hard stuff, but I'm worthy enough to be considered. I'm worthy, you thought enough of me to consider me, to go through for your name's sake and for your glory. And so that's where I come to. And I tell you, like I said, a lot has transpired in my life. In my life, I'm talking about from my infancy, from my new birth, from the time that I accepted Christ as my personal Savior, received the Spirit, been baptized in his name. You know, life has been transformed, and all these other stuff that has transpired, and opposition and rejection and you know, the Satan buffing at me and attacking me and all the stuff that I've, all the stuff that I went through, jealousy, envy, strife from the saints, and just all the stuff that I've been through. I look at it to date, and rejection, just a lot of stuff that I've been through. I look back at it and I say, you know what? There's a lot that I could say, but I'm gonna say this. Thank you for considering me. Thank you, Father, for looking at me and thinking enough of me to be even be considered. Because you knew at the end of the day that Job would not curse you and die. So you knew you was gonna win that little challenge from the get. You knew that you would win that challenge, Father, when you presented it to Satan. And so now, when I look at my life, you knew that the challenge being presented, that I'm going to pass the test, that I'm going to go through and I'm going to be victorious. So we got to learn to trust God. And again, we're going to go through some hard, hard stuff, but we're going to have to learn to trust God. We are in the dispensation of being pampered. We are some pampered saints. We are prim and proper pampered saints. If you look at the days of the apostles and all the things that they went through, they were martyred for his name's sake. I mean, they were killed, they were stoned, boiled in oil. I mean, they were not playing, beheaded. They went through, I mean, seriously, physically, their bodies were taken and they were suffering for the name's sake of Christ, for the Christ's name's sake. And we are pampered saints. Well, we go through stuff, we may not be liked, people lie on us, they spread rumors, they gossip, say that stuff starts to growth because we're in different relationships and different things that happen to us, and we make bad decisions and we fall short because of the lust of our flesh and all this other stuff, and on and on and on. But we are so pampered because we have not experienced the fullness of persecution as like our forefathers. And it's almost like God is saying, listen, you're going to have to brace yourself, because if you're not careful, when the real test comes, this is only just preliminary. So when the real test comes and when the real trial comes, will you be able to stand, or will you curse my name and die? Would you curse me and die, or will you stand? And so we have to be careful in this day and age. Everything is not going to go our way. You can name it, claim it all you want to. You can speak it and declare and decree it all you want to. Some things are not going to go your way. It's not. The reason why everything happened the way Jesus had declared it is because him and his Father had the same will. So everything he asked was already in the will of God. But with us, sometimes it's questionable. The things that we ask may not necessarily be in his will. It's in our flesh. It's in a fleshly desire that we have, that we hold on to, that we hope that is in the will of God for the most part, but it's not in his will for us. So we have to be careful. So just be thankful and be prayerful in this season. Thankful because God considered you to go through. He considered you. He didn't have to consider you. So if he considered you, he knew that you had it in you to make it through. That you had it, you have what it takes to be victorious and to be a winner in this race. Because this is a race. This race is not given to the swift nor to the strong, but it's he that endureth unto the end. This is a long race. You know, don't get caught up in the hype. You see many people, they start out running. Ooh, running, and they slow down. That steady pace. We have to take it one day at a time. So be blessed in knowing, yes, Satan may be on your track, but thank God for being considered to go through, because God considered you, so he knew what your end would be, that you would be victorious. And we have to condition ourselves so that when we go through, we can acknowledge God and bless his name and not charge him foolishly. Amen. And not curse his name and curse into his face and die. We have to trust God in this season, because Satan is out there presenting himself like an angel of light, but the devil is a liar. My prayer is that he be exposed and for the liar that he is and the deceiver that he is, and we see the light and we walk therein. So be blessed and thank God for being considered. So despite of all that you're going through, you're a winner. You are a winner. You are victorious. I don't care what it is. You may be lacking. You may be suffering in your body. You may be going through all kinds of stuff. And it doesn't matter what you're going through. It matters in the sense of it hurts. You're going through it. And you feel it. And, you know, it's current. It's right now. And it's not like, you know, you feel that thing. And that's, I'm not saying that, I'm not like downplaying it, because I think sometimes we do that too. We downplay, you know, our situations as if it ain't nothing. It is something. It's something to you. And if you're going through it, it's hard. It's hard. If you feel whatever you're feeling right now, you're feeling what you're feeling right now. When you read the book of Job, Job felt that thing. Read his words. He felt it like, oh, he cursed everything but God. He cursed the day he was born. He cursed everything. Everything he cursed. He went through. So we don't want to belittle the fact that you're going through, because I think a lot of times we think, you ain't going through nothing. No, you're going through some stuff and it hurts and you're suffering and it's hard. And maybe you may feel by yourself, but you're not alone. God thought of you enough to consider you. So while you're going through, just know God's got me. He knows I got what it takes. I got the right stuff so that I'm going to make it. I'm going to be victorious. I'm going to see it through to the end, and I'm going to receive my crown in glory. And guess what? Not only that, I'm going to reap some stuff as I go along the way, because he desires for us to prosper even as our soul prospereth. So while I'm going through in this soul and I'm being afflicted, I know that I'm going to be blessed in my soul too, and he's going to bless me in the natural as well as in the spiritual. So may the blessings of the Lord be upon you, and thank God that you are being considered to go through in this season, and God's got something special for you. So go through, take on the joy of the Lord, and go through, and continue to bless his name as you go through. Continue to read your word and be in prayer and consecration as you go through. Continue to bless somebody else and share your testimony so you can help somebody else while you're going through. The enemy would have us to just bury our heads in our bedrooms and be sad and all day long and you know, just be depressed and oppressed while we're going through. But the devil's a lie. Rejoice while you're going through. Have your moment and then thank God. And that's what Job did. He said he blessed his name. He said, the Lord giveth, the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Like, yes, at the end of the day, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So we want to find ourselves blessing the name of the Lord at all times. You know, we say that as cliche, but there needs to be some times where it may be hard to bless him. It's going to be hard to bless his name, but we want to find ourselves blessing him. Why? Because he thought enough of me to consider me to go through. Have you considered my servant? You fill in the blank. And may the blessings of the Lord be upon you until next time. And shalom unto you and yours always. In Jesus' name, amen.